15 days back, I got a call from Dr. Thakole sir. I heard about him a lot, so I said that I'll come. I am not familiar and habitual to talk and give lectures, but try to do justice for the subject given. Basically, I started BBG, small story to it. I completed my engineering by way of earn-learn scheme, and then joined Tata Motors as a graduate in the engineer in 1994. I am from Raimatpur, which is a small town in Satara district. And after joining Tata Motors, most of the people from Satara district are workers category in Tata Motors. So I joined as a M1 category. So they started approaching me for jobs for their relatives, who is 7 pass, 10 pass, and all that, 10 fail. And Tata Motors was kind enough. I approached Tata Motors management that I got some 18 people from my village and who are ready to any kind of job. So can kindly give us some job. So they told me that being an employee of Tata Motors will not give it to you. But if you have some social organization, we'll give it to that organization. I found one organization called Bharat Vikas Pratishthan when I was in college, thinking I was reading Swami Vivekananda, some stories and all that. So I was thinking that I should do something different in life. And I found that organization called Bharat Vikas Pratishthan. And that with that organization, I started this Umesh Mane, who joined me from day one, who is also a cousin brother of mine, from Raimatpur only. So he started taking operations responsibility. And we started with 8 people in 1997. In the car plant, Indica plant erection was going on. And within 2 years' time, we grew to around 200 people. And in 2001, I resigned from Tata Motors and started this housekeeping and services activities of full-time venture. And then we, I decided that not to work in Pune only. So I started in Bangalore. We went in 2001, we started in Bangalore, then we went to Hyderabad, then we went to Chennai. And then we got first big opportunity in government. In 2003, we got Parliament House contract. That's the first government contract we got to maintain entire Parliament House library building, which is newly built building of around 6 lakh square feet area. Then we got, because of our good quality work and all that, we got main Parliament House, then we got Prime Minister's House, then we got Parliament, the Vigyan Bhavan. Now, we started Delhi operations with 30 people. Today we have got more than 6,500 people working in Delhi only. And BBG started from 8 people, today we are having 30,000 people. And by year end, we will be having 40,000 people on our rolls. We are the now biggest in this field in the country. This is what employee growth is there. I decided name Bharat Vikas in 1991 when I was 19 years old. And with God's virtue and greatness that we are now spread across the country. Right from Guwahati to Chennai, Badri, Haridwar, all across the country we are present. We are into various services. We give mechanized housekeeping, landscaping, gardening, security, waste management, electrical maintenance, all types of services where manpower is essential parameter of the service. We are into that services. Then operational maintenance, electrical projects. And a client list, we have got more than 400 customers across the country. But Tata Motors across the country, we work for the Volkswagen, Fiat, Mahindra, ITC, Hindustan Motors, Hindustan Unilever, ABB. There are a lot of clients are with them. Then Rashtrapati Bhavan, Parliament House, Prime Minister's House and Office, both are maintained by BBG. Mantralaya, AMS, ONGC, NPCIL, Delhi CBI, CVC, Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, Talcottara Stadium, Subtering Hospital, everything is with us. All main establishments are with us. These are the pictorial presentations. Swami Pada Ramdev Patanjali, Shirdi Sai Baba Sansthan, all main establishments. Besides that, as a social responsibility, I maintain 15 temples in Maharashtra. So Santa Gadhi Maharaj was visiting our grandfather and grandmother. So I thought that after electronics engineering, I came into housekeeping business and now growing. So in 2004, I decided to do free of cost working for these temples. Because our temples are dirty, so I started with Alandi. Then Pandharpur, Tuzapur, Jyotiba, Jezuri, all 15 temples in Maharashtra, I am doing free of cost. And some people started now paying also. So these are the things are there. So basically, I think time is short, so I need to compact myself. So in our business, skills are important other than degrees. So till today, we grown with a phased manner. Gradually we grown. But I see big opportunities in near future. And to grow 40,000 people, it took 13-14 years. I see we can grow around 1 lakh people in next 2-3 years time. So to have this rapid expansion, and now I'm thinking to go outside India. The Dubai is there, Singapore is there. This week I visited Germany, I visited USA. There also I see a lot of opportunities for this kind of business because skill is an issue. So we are now thinking to develop and set up a training institute. Yeah, initially we are training people, but it's happening in that 10 लोगों के बीच में 2 लोगों को डाल दिया तो अपने आप ट्रेन होते गए. सो इट वॉज वी नेवर फील दैट वी शुड हैव अ सेपरेट ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट और ट्रेनिंग दिस थिंग. बट रिसेंटली आई मेट यशवंतराव चव्हाण यूनिवर्सिटी चांसलर एंड मैडम देशमुख इज ऑल्सो हियर कृष्ण कुमार साहब दैट वी शुड हैव प्रॉपर ट्रेनिंग एस्टैब्लिशमेंट फॉर आवर ट्रेनिंग थिंग. एंड रिसेंटली वी गॉट दिस ACSY मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट दे हैव गिवन अस 3 प्रोजेक्ट्स इन फैसिलिटी मैनेजमेंट हॉस्पिटल एंड हेल्थ केयर टू ट्रेन 8,000 पीपल इन ईच सेक्टर. So we have started training these people. Out of that, almost 10,000 people we have trained and employed in BBG as well as in other sectors. In Yavatmal one center is there, various, and we are targeting those people who are not educated, below 5th, below 8th. So those who are not getting employment anywhere else, we are targeting those stuff so that we can give them skills and we can train them well. And wherever we are giving outside city, in Delhi we have got more than 5,500 people working from Chhattisgarh district. In Prime Minister's house, Prime Minister's office, we need to have proper security checks. So I am taking Satara people to work there and I am giving them accommodation facility and one-time food. So in Satara, as the fifth fellow, he works in any industry, he will get maximum 2,500 rupees or 3,000 rupees payment. And by coming to and fro, he will spend 1,000 rupees on that in transportation. So he will save 2,000 rupees. If he works in Delhi, he will get ESI, PF, bonus, gratuity, all that I do completely. I do not do any compromise on statutory compliance. In fact, I give more than what they should get. And that's what we are doing. And then he saves around 5,000 rupees in Delhi and he sends 4,000 to his house. So that's the way we are operating. So this is the... And in this, we have developed around more than 50 different training programs, 2 months courses, and we are training the people. Now, with ICMU, we are planning to have, after 12th, 1 year supervisor course, which we call as a diploma. Then second is advanced diploma and third is degree. That's what we are planning to do. We are in advanced stage of discussions and finalization of the scope. And then for marketing also, we are thinking to have MBA in facility management. So that we can have, if he has to do marketing in government sector like municipal corporations, he needs to have different skill sets in PSUs, in corporates. So we are thinking that we are taking from third B or C grade MBA schools, we are taking MBA. But still we need to give them 1 year course. So we are thinking to have that kind of course inbuilt to their course so that we can get ready-made people who can go directly on the field. So these are different courses we are trying to do. And we are trying to adopt global practices so that we can have best practices in the country and in our training and all that. Recently I visited Germany and I say that we see that German people, we say that they are the best in the quality. I try to analyze why they are the best. So after my study, a little bit, 4-5 days they have a plumbing course of 3 years. They have got carpentry course of 3 years. Whatever course, they have got 3 years course. And unless until that man is perfect, they don't give certificate to him. So if Tyler is there, he needs to have that 1 mm accuracy should be there. So if that kind of training is given to them, then they will produce the best machinery in the world. So that's the reason. So I think here, university and whatever, we should have that kind of courses that rather than having degrees of BAs and BCOMs and all that, we should have the degree he should self-sustainable to earn himself. So my urge to all these, to you and everybody, that we should design the courses to, so that with that education, person should have his livelihood on his own. So, and with knowledge sharing and my request to you all that we are into practical things. We are into working style and all that. So we need the expertise in syllabus designing, soft skills. Whatever we know, we are trying to do with our limited knowledge. But people like you, if you can join together and we can have some set of, because this, if you construct 1,000 square foot, around 10,000 square foot area, we require at least 2 to 3 people to serve that area. So that is the benchmark in industry. if you this building I think is 40 lakh square foot. This entire campus is 40 lakh square foot. So 40 lakh divided by 10,000 into 3 or 4 people is the requirement of services people over here. AC maintenance, electrical maintenance, housekeeping, security, electronic security, lift operation maintenance. So that kind of scope is, so this market is growing very big way. And India, recent report I heard that India is having services segment in this, what we are operating into, is having around 90,000 crore market. And we do not get skilled people. So developing skill to these people, in fact, I would like to share that in Yashwantrao Chavan Hospital, we are giving employment to widows. Those people, ladies who are thrown by their husbands and all that, we have got more than 300 ladies working inside these areas, and they are giving opportunity to those who are just passed out, they never went to school also. And they are getting their livelihoods by better means, they are getting ESI, PF, bonus, gratuity, all types of social securities are there with them. So I am trying to do something different in life and need your blessings and support to do something better what I am doing. So thank you.
Yeah.